Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Solomon Jagwe. Thanks again for joining me today. I'm going to be showing you a little bit of the process I'm using with the Daz Bridge to Blender over here. And so the idea is to get this character from Daz into Blender using the bridge. And the way I do it is I go up to the top on the scripts, and then bridges, and then I click on Daz to Blender. Okay, so now there are a number of requests that have come in. People have been asking me how, once you send this character from Daz to Blender, like how do you actually transform it, scale it, rotate it, and all that? Because I think some people are having those issues, and also they're wondering why the textures are not showing up. So let me see if I can walk you through real quick. So we're gonna click on that Daz to Blender bridge, and I'm gonna try to keep this running so that you get a sense of how long it takes. So, because sometimes it looks like nothing is happening and yet something's actually happening in the background. Okay, so I'm gonna click on Daz to Blender. Make sure it's sub D0 is selected, and click accept and accept. So let it go through. And each character will have like a different response. For example, on the screen, the morph's missing, it might bring up a dialog box that says, do you want to accept if something like this is not available? Just go through. Because this behemoth, for example, I noticed that dialog box popped up. Okay, so it's done. It doesn't take very long, depending on the scene that you have or how many objects there are. So this character, and let me make sure I turn on the textures so you see that the textures are actually there. So for those of you who have been saying that, the textures are not showing up, the bridge is supposed to take these textures automatically from Daz Studio to Blender. All right, so then we come to Blender. And now I'm assuming you've already installed the Daz bridge in Blender. And if you haven't, then you definitely have to go to your preferences and the add-ons and make sure that you have it installed. So for example, for mine, when I click on add-ons and I tap in Daz, so it's there. It's already installed. Make sure that's checked. The check mark is good. Okay. And it shows up here. All right. So now just click on that and click on import new Genesis 3.8. So now in Blender, for some reason, and maybe they will do this later on, but you are not able to bring props from here to Blender yet. It's only characters that are coming in. For 3ds Max and in 3ds Max, I'm able to send the entire set from Daz Studio to 3ds Max, but in Blender, for some reason, that hasn't been achieved. All right, so please don't close Daz while you're importing this, because the file right now is in a temp folder. So just click on import over here, and now this is the part that is kind of painful, is that for some reason Blender takes a long time to respond, and usually up at the top it says not responding. Yeah, and so just give it a, be patient. All right, so there it is. So the character has come in now, and we can push this out of the way over here. So this is the character, and it comes in with a full rig for the face and the body. And so when you press S, it's not gonna like do the scaling like you're normally used to. So what you need to do is use this gizmo on the bottom of the model. That's the rig. And for example, to rotate, simply click on that and you're able to rotate the character. And it's undo. And if you need to scale, then you need to go over to the right hand side and just select all of those and type in, for example, if you want to scale it like 3 times, type in a 3 and press enter. And as you can tell, the model has been scaled. If you need to bring it down again, just select all of them at one time, go type 1, press enter, and the model is back to the full size that you want. Now, for the textures are there, but you just need to switch to viewport shading so that the textures actually come through. So as you can see, the textures are now loading. They're, depending on how much memory you have or how fast your computer is, it may take a minute for all the textures to display, but the textures are there. You just need to be able to toggle the textures so that they show up in the scene. And so that is the part that I wanted to point out, that sometimes it seems like it hasn't, you know, nothing has loaded, but it is there. The textures are there in Blender, and you just need to be able to toggle. Let me frame it. And depending on if you have, if you have Eevee or Cycles, so this is what you can, you'll be able to tell if you know, you're using Cycles or Eevee in terms of once you've toggled it on the top corner right there. Because right now I'm just showing the textures, but I'm not really rendering. Okay, and over in Daz Studio, I just need to toggle NVIDIA iRes so you can compare and see if the textures look as good. So here goes, iRes is gonna kick in so you can see the difference calculating. And if you have multiple GPU cards, it will be able to go faster, again, depending on how your machine is set up. But like I said, the textures are there and you're able to scale, you're able to rotate and able to transform the model. So for all of you guys who have been having some trouble, I hope that this tutorial helps and that you can actually see that this model that was in Daz Studio was sent to Blender with the textures on it and that you're able to scale and rotate and translate using the gizmo at the bottom of the character. So that's the one that you need to use. And so here's the model in Daz Studio. So there's a, there is a difference in terms of the quality, because what you're looking at here in Blender is simply the viewport displaying the textures but not rendering. So I'm gonna try to switch to rendered. I'm gonna click on rendered. Let's see what it looks like. So it's loading. Let's see how long that takes. And in the meantime, you can look back at this one in Daz Studio. And there are emissions are, there's a, this particular image, they are two types of eye material, so you can swap back and forth. But you can see how nice that looks. Yeah, so here is here's what it looks like in Blender. So there is a slight difference because the render engines are again handling the textures differently, and you may have to go in and adjust the settings to suit, you know, the type of you know, quality that you want. But you know, the bump maps are there, normal maps are there, spec maps, everything is there. So just a matter of customizing it to get the look that you want. But yes, you're able to send a model from Daz Studio using the bridge, you know, the scripts up at the top, and send it to Blender in with textures, and you're able to transform, scale, and rotate. And I think the cool thing is that Blender is free and Daz Studio is free. Now, the models are not free, so those ones you have to pay some money. But I mean, if you're planning on a short film, for example, and you'd like to render your models in Blender using Eevee or Cycles, this is, I think, a very good ecosystem to be able to take your models, your whole library that you've been investing in DAZ Studio and from DAZ 3D, and then take it to DAZ, to Blender through the DAZ Bridge to Blender. So I hope that was helpful. Thanks, guys. Please don't forget to subscribe. Take a minute to subscribe to my channel. Click like on the video to support my channel, and please share your comments. If you're a Blender user, do please share your experience. And those of you who have been able to use the bridge, kindly let me know what the experience is like. But I think this is really, really cool for indie developers and people who are either hobbyists or who are wanting to create your short films. So thanks, guys. Again, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're alerted when I post a new video. Thanks again. Peace out. And dare to dream big. Never give up on your dream. Thank you. Bye-bye.